welcome back to Bloodborne. We are going to be walking away from that giant guy. Instead, we're going to be going this way. Oh! Look, a crow!
Well, that guy's still there.
And I can kill him with two quick attacks now. So I wonder what happened to the... See, and that guy's still there. Because there used to be several enemies all the way down at the bottom, and they're all gone. I wonder if the purple clouds had bad effects on them. But this means that if I go up here, we can reasonably expect... Yeah. You see that?
Yeah.
If I did, like, one more damage.
Oh, the big guy's not there anymore.
I kind of like the big guys just because they had tiny hats. Cannot believe that. Yeah, the entire place actually seems better lit now, with the giant red moon and the purple sky. Let's see if the chicken foot... What? There he is. He was sleeping. So now that I know that, if I had crept up on him, probably could have smacked him. Actually, let's look at my health. See? It goes up 2. Oh, and if I put that other health-regenerating gem in it... If I had several of the health-regenerating gems, I'd put them all in a second weapon that I liked.
And then just carried it around.
Yeah, and then I'd switch to it whenever I needed it. Okay, so good news, the chicken foot priests seem like they're gone. So I wonder if anything's different in here now.
What's that?
So the answer appears to be yes.
What's that?
But it's not attacking me and I can't... I can knock on it. Alrighty.
You hunters can resist the intoxication.
Seriously, what's that?
It's a guy.
But why?
The nightmare will stand. Okay, yeah, I don't like this. I am getting out of here.
It's gonna follow you.
Okay, so the dialogue. Yeah, you're right. Here it goes, following me. The dialogue made it sound like it was after me, after Hunter specifically. Okay, we are gonna come back and kill that person later.
It still seems very weird.
Oh, I wonder if the changing of the moon made some people aggressive who otherwise would have been friendly. Yeah, see, this area is practically daylight. I don't even really need my lantern anymore. These people are still alive. No response. And Yeah, something bad probably happened to him. I will go and check on Gilbert in a bit, because I really am going to need to go back there in order to refill my collection.
Looks like all of those guys are gone.
My collection of blood vials.
No, those guys are still there.
Yeah, there's still two of them. Which is fine. I can beat two of them. Yeah. This is practically daylight. In some areas. Come on, Executioner. You think you're scary. I know better. Yeah, so wherever that place leads, next lantern I find, I am going to go back, check on Gilbert, kill everybody, and hope that I can be refilled up to maximum. Blood vials. Handy. I might not even need to go back. I mean, I will, so I can check. Oh, it's another one of the creepy spider guys. Creepy spider guy got me hit. I was concerned about him. See?
Oh, was that his fault or is that your fault?
Well, it's definitely his fault. So the voice said, "Oh, amygdala." So, is that this guy, or what? Look at him. Yeah, those guys... Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Those people have 9 arms? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
They've got a bunch of arms.
Yeah, they got a bunch of arms. Okay, so we're just gonna run straight through, and I hope he doesn't grab me.
Okay. He didn't.
There he goes. Yeah, so he's slow. I don't mind. And now we'll see where this spits me out at. Look. Yarugul, Unseen Village. It's the same place where that jail was.
You're kidding. I don't know whatever the hell that is.
They're villagers. But now they're covered in blood and spawn out of seemingly nowhere. Right. Yeah, this... Oh, look. It's another one of the... I don't know what you... Ow! What are you doing? That's another one of the spider people. Oh, okay, it's a broken statue.
You can hear him coming out of somewhere.
Is that one of the wheelchair ones? No. Okay, it's just...
Did you see the lamp?
Yeah. Look. Many of the surrounding buildings are covered by them. Ah. Oh. See? 1, 2, 3. I don't like any of this. Look. The area that I've already been to. There's another one. So I wonder if that... Oh, 3 hit. So I wonder if they're unlimited in this area. And they just spawn out of... spawn out of nowhere. Yeah.
You don't get anything for killing them.
I did the first time. So these must spawn in unlimited numbers.
That's fun.
So, do you want me to keep on going into the village, or do you want me to go back, check on Gilbert, and resupply?
You might want to resupply.
And check on. Is 28,000 enough to level? It's not anymore. Wow.
Welcome home. What is it? Very well. Let me. Farewell, good hunter.
Okay, Gilbert, I will check on you. And then we can see if anything else has changed for the worse. Because if all of the villagers are replaced with the unlimitedly respawning blood villagers with 10 times as much health, that would count as a bad development. Oh, look. Yeah, it's already different.
What if that was Gilbert?
Walmart.
That was Gilbert! You killed Gilbert!
You know, you could save a lot of time if you just say, I killbert. Yeah, what? But Gilbert said that he couldn't walk. Strengthens visceral attacks do 20% more damage.
You know, if Gilbert died, maybe Yusefka died.
You know what? Yeah, Yusefka and... Were there any other people?
No, I don't think so.
Oh, there's a guy in the church. But we already know that he's still alive. Yeah, I'll go back and see about Yusefka. But yeah, you're right. That was probably Gilbert. Ow. And I'm stuck. But in order to get back to where Yusefka is, I'll have to go... through the... No, I could actually reach it.
You could just go back.
Yeah. Ow. I can reach it through that, the plaza near the beginning, right?
Yes.
Alright. That is what I will do.
Well, yeah, because remember you opened up those doors.
I opened up that gate. Yeah. And even if Yusefka's not dead, maybe we should kill her. Just because obviously she was... All those people that we were sending there...
She killed.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, technically you killed them. But she turned them into something terrible.
As if there's anything terrible about being a comical blue monster. Yosefka was very nice near the beginning of the game, but...
Maybe, and she turned all crazy.
Yeah, the changing of the moon did something. I kind of want to just wander around everywhere and see if anything else has changed. You are cursed. Because I was expecting that many of the enemies would be more powerful, but instead it seems like it's just the same with better lighting. And Gilbert.
Poor Gilbert. He seemed so nice.
And he did kind of warn us that he wasn't long for the world. Oh, actually, we don't even need to go all the way around through the side because we opened up that door that went in, didn't we?
Unless she closed it.
Well, this would be the part where we find out.
Yeah. She did. Alright, well, you can go around. She did threaten you last time.
Yeah, why did we listen to her instead of just going and killing her anyway?
I don't know. Honestly.
Oh, there's gonna be an octopus man down here somewhere, if I remember correctly. Yeah, there he is. And I don't want him to steal my insight. I do not appreciate his durability. You remember, we got this shortcut by going through that poison area.
Right.
Maybe if I go back there, like, maybe not now, but there were other paths in the poison area, right?
I don't know if there were, or if there was just a bigger room.
Okay, well, at some point we'll have to check it out. And I know this is just a pebble. It's a pebble.
You might want to heal.
Their corpses are still here. That is very, very unusual. All of the other corpses in the game disappear. Maybe the door will stay open this time. That's really actually kind of creepy that this one part of the game is acting different than everywhere else. Oh man, maybe it was possible to turn those people back into humans.
Probably not.
Yeah, but what if? That would mean that we killed all those poor people that we sent here.
Just in case she turns violent, you might want to.
This is very sensible. Because
she's not saying anything.
Yeah, because like, right at now. This point, she was already yelling at me. Oh, maybe she turned into something.
Well... Smacking stuff is how you let people know you're there.
I'm a good house guest. That goes upstairs. Yeah, maybe she's dead. I'm not sure what's...
I don't want to just talk to her.
Yeah, I'll talk to her.
I mean, it doesn't look good at all, but I might want to talk to her.
God, I'm nauseous. Have you found this? It's progressing. I can see things. I knew it. I'm different. I'm no beast. Oh, God, it feels awful. But it proves that I'm chosen. Don't you see how they writhe? Writhe inside my head. It's rather rapturous.
Oh, that sounds an awful lot like her going to transform into something. So should I just...
Does she have anything else to say?
God, I'm nauseous.
No.
Smack her.
Okay. One smack coming up. So I got 3,500 and... umbilical cord. Okay, because she killed everybody here. And there's, like, everything she was saying made it sound like she was going to transform. Oh, that's... okay. Cool. I've got 2 1-third of umbilical cords. Yeah, so we've killed Gilbert. We've killed Yusefka. We're just not very good at keeping friends.
The guy at the church seemed okay.
Hey, maybe he's gonna start killing people next. Turning them into, like, red monsters. So where do we go from here? We should probably go back to the village. Because we've got the village, the Nightmare Frontier, and...
you've got the castle.
The castle. So, this is the part where we decide, where do we go next? I think I will go to the village. So we'll go to the village. And then maybe we can go back to the castle. And that underground poison area that I wanted to go back and check out. You know what's creepy about these big guys? You can't target them. Which almost makes me think that... I don't want to say that they're friendly, but normally the only things you can't target are friendlies. What was that? Oh, it's the guy shooting me. Come on, villagers. So I will go towards the rest of the villagers in a bit. Hey, that's 2. If I get one more, I am going straight back and upgrading my cleaver.
Oh.
Oh, and I'm increasingly close to the... Yeah. Its shadows are... Oh, look, that's its hand, or its face, or...
Gross.
Look, you can see its chin hair. Ah, high definition. That's what you're good for, showing us the chin hair of monsters.
Now run away! Oh. Okay, we'll still run away.
Yeah!
Yeah, see, they do give you echoes the first time that you kill them. I think the issue is that they come back. Iron Yargul. I'll try that on, but... Okay, I'm just gonna sprint for it again. Ha 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 ha! Oh! My decision-making. I successfully sprinted for it, though.
Well, now you know.
Now I know to go in there and pull the lever.
Well, it probably won't work.
You're right. It's probably a device is not currently operable. Either way, I still need to go back there in order to get my body back. Come here, guys. Yeah. These guys seem sturdier than the guys in the Forbidden Forest, and yet they give less. So I'm just going to run back there, retrieve my body, and then I guess... Did you see what moved my body to?
Yeah.
That's not where I jumped off of, but that's fine.
So.
Yeah, I'm gonna totally leave that place alone because that's probably just a shortcut. Okay, Yahara Ghoul. I'm gonna go explore you, see? Kill them, they come back.
Look around the corner to the right, though.
This way?
Yeah, because that guy came back, too.
I do not appreciate the regenerating enemies in this way. So how should I handle this? Should I just, like, sprint through them?
I don't know.
Okay, that's what we're gonna do. Good! Now I'm inside.
There's even more people.
Yeah, but these guys don't give enough to be desperately concerned about killing all of them.
What is that bell ringing? I think they're coming back. It's possible if...
Yep, I had already killed that one. Maybe there's something later, so I can head back outside, or... Oh, remember we saw those in the... in and did the, she bring in the
them,
chalice.
Did she bring them to life?
Yeah, in the chalice, she brought enemies with the glowing red eyes that spawned around her. So it's possible that she was bringing people to life.
Wow. Who knows?
Yeah, because this is the same place that had the prison. So I'm not surprised to see it full of jail cells.
Oh, he's dead.
Okay.
And what's that?
Bolt Damp Blood Gem. The Mensis ritual must be stopped lest we all become beasts. Bolt attack up 16.5%. Oh, that sounds like that would be good. But I remember what happened the last time I tried putting in elemental stuff. My bad arcane ended up making it actually very weak. Well, time to head outside.
Alright, well. Nothing sounds good out here. So you can hear that, right?
Yeah. Not sure what it is. So I could either go in there, or I can be civilized and go through the door that's locked.
Look, come on, look down.
Down here?
Yeah.
Oh, look, I can drop off.
What are those things?
Oh, they look kind of like crying people. And there's another big creepy guy. So should I drop down or go down into the tunnel?
We could drop down.
Alright, I hope I don't die. Bolt paper. Actually, more than hoping I don't die, I hope that the big guy doesn't, like, reach over and kill me. I wonder if that's like the Weeping Villagers in...
That's what it
Homework.
Looks like.
That is exactly what it is. Like, ow. Those are some aggressive old ladies. Those are extremely aggressive old ladies.
So I think there's one more. Well, or maybe not.
So I can go down, I can go over.
Well, they're gonna start coming back.
See? Ah, there they go.
You know what? Maybe it's those big guys that are bringing them back.
Oh, that time it dropped some. I don't... That can't be safe. And yet, it's not trying to attack me. Oh, that guy is... Oh, look, there's two of them.
And that guy.
And a machine gunner. Oh, that is just... the very definition of fun. Yeah, you guys are fat. You can't fit through the door. That's okay. Ah, I'm sorry I said you were fat. You're big boned. I wish I had some way of knowing which ones would come back to life and which ones wouldn't. I'm gonna sprint for this guy. Okay. But now that this guy is not nearly as concerning. Tiny tinnitus. What's a tiny tinnitus?
Okay, you might want to get moving because they're coming back.
They're coming back. Oh, and there's Gunner Man.
This seems awful.
Yeah, I think I might actually like the village if it weren't for... How am I supposed to get in there? There's, like, nothing in here. There's no doors.
Maybe it's on the front.
Maybe it is on the front and you have to kill everybody in order to get to it. Yeah. And it doesn't open from the side. What fun! But at least I have a tiny tinnitus.
Which, who knows what that even does.
Crap. 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 I do not like the village. I like my enemies to stay dead and only come back when I go back to the Hunter's Dream. This is enough to make me want to go explore the Canehurst Castle more. Not out of any particular fondness for Canehurst Castle, but mainly the fact that the enemies there stay dead. Oh, I'm not... Yeah, see? Bell ringing, and then enemies.
The bell isn't good, man. I told you.
We have entirely too much cowbell.
But where is it coming from?
Hey, look, but I've got enough bloodstone chunks in order to upgrade it.
Good.
Damn you, fiend! Yeah. Oh, yes, look. There's so many. Oh, that is bad. That is
so
bad. Why? I don't know. But now I'm dead.
Like, that's just terrible.
It doesn't even seem fair, no. And I don't have any of the cold blood that I could crush in order to get enough money to upgrade it. So the real question is how badly I want to get that 30,000 back. I think I'm just gonna run for it and then try and escape. that I can't roll through them. What am I doing? Yeah, bell-winging lady, you get chopped in half.
So they won't come back now, or?
I don't know. I don't like her anyway. Because I saw in that other room that I went into, she rang the bell and like three of them came out of the blood pool.
It's all your...
Ouch. I don't have any way of getting back up if I drop down there to go get it. Oh, crap.
Yeah, because it just looked like it went farther and farther in.
Yeah. And I can't even get up here now that I've dropped down.
So you have to.
Yeah. Well, that's just a bundle of fun. So I'll see if I can get it back, and then
what?
Well, that really is the million-dollar question. Oh, and she's not dead. It was right over there. I could try using a bold hunter's mark. I think that's what I'm gonna do. I don't like this place. Oh, look at that. Sneaking up on me. And more of them sneaking up on me.
So then once you pick up your body, you'll use it and then go back to a lantern?
Yeah. Well, no. It sends you back to the hunter's dream.
Okay.
Yeah. Or at least that's what the description makes it sound like it does. Okay. Yes. What?
Did it not work?
It has a time to trigger. See? Watch.
There you go.
Okay.
That area. That just sucks.
Yeah. If only I had some reliable way of knowing... Okay, so it doesn't send you back to the Hunter's Dream, it sends you back to the previous lane. But I'm going back to the Hunter's Dream. And then I think I'm going to go to the castle. Go pretty much anywhere other than Yaragul Unseen Village. Even the Nightmare Frontier might be better than that. We'll find out. Yeah, 153. I'll take that. extra damage. And if only I had 5 bloodstone chunks, I could go up again.
Welcome. What is it? Very well. Let me...
Oh, now it's making... I would like more damage.
Farewell, good hunt.
Well, thank you very much for watching. Yorugul Unseen Village is terrible. We'll do something else next time. ¶¶